The flood buries life.
I'll be right here. Hold it, Mario.
The Bible is the key to help us understand geological features around the earth.
The flood began about 4,350 years ago.
Let's just tell Mommy to go to war first. That's easier, right?
When we look at geological features
around the earth,
many of them are radically different from anything being formed.
You can put it in there.
Like thick mud layers over continents, or coal seams covering entire states, or fossil graveyards, or frozen mammoths, or miles of underground sea passages, or thick ice sheets moving over continents, or craters of supervolcanoes, or canyons cut thousands of feet. It looks like the present is not the best way to explain.
I was just trying to play around. Got all these pictures to help.
The Bible, however, offers another way to explain.
Have you taken pictures of all these?
Yes.
Noah's flood
and
was a global judgment, a violent catastrophe upon the earth. Based on this truth,
I know you're going to start taking more pictures.
Scientists are developing a series of models to explain how the flood and its aftermath could have shaped the world today. In the course of the flood, erosion washed away mountains of rock in some places, while miles of mud and sand were piled up in others. The earth's crust was thickened in some places and thinned in others. Like jostled ice cubes.